Hello and welcome, I'm Ms. Lauren, and let's talk about some witchy books. It doesn't have to be Halloween for you to get into something a little bit magical and mystical, especially if you've already run through a lot of those magical classics. So let's get started with some of my favorite witchy suggestions. First of all, a really cute new book that came out last year is called Eva Evergreen, Semi-Magical Witch, and that's by Julie Abbe. It is about a young witch who's kind of a late bloomer, isn't as advanced as a lot of her peers, and it's time for her to face her big witchcraft quest. A quest that she has to pass within a year or be banned from magic forever. So the stakes are very high, but the characters are very cute, and Eva is way charming. You will really empathize with her character, and you'll want to see how she's able to get herself out of this bind that ends up being a situation that most really talented mature witches wouldn't be able to handle. So definitely give it a try. If you see the cover for this one, big time Miyazaki Kiki's Delivery Service vibes for those of you who are animated film buffs. My next favorite is a graphic novel, and this one's been around for a while. It's a whole series, but even the sequels are just as strong as the first volume, and that's Witch Boy by Molly Knox Ostertag. Our main character, Aster, lives in a magical family where girls are witches and boys are shapeshifters, and they're very, very strict about that. The consequences they believe for going back and forth between the two are dire. And so when Aster finds out that he's not really into shapeshifting and definitely has more of a talent for witchcraft, that means he's kind of left to have to study it in secret. And the fallout of which tracks through the mystery of finding out where some of his shapeshifter cousins are disappearing to. And Aster's the only one who can really accomplish this quest. And for my last witchy read of this video, I really want to recommend to you The Okay Witch, and that's by Emma Steinhellner. This is another graphic novel, and it is just, it's a coming of age story. It is a story about finding your place in your family, in your community, and finding your place within history. Moth Hush is a young witch who has no idea that she comes from a long line of very powerful witches because her mom has been living in the human world kind of as one of them and really doesn't want to have anything to do with witchcraft. So it's up to Hush to do a little investigation with the help of a cat that is basically her familiar and is animated by the soul of a family friend who has since departed. So you've got a ghost cat, you've got a really resilient young witch, and in this book I especially like that the bad guys get it in the end, and they really stick it to the people who are causing the most harm. So please check out The Okay Witch. I honestly swear that you will not regret it. It's one of my very favorite graphic novels of the last couple years. So those are my witchy reads. Remember, you can check any of these out on our online catalog. If you need help placing a hold, there's gonna be a librarian waiting for you. So just remember to like and subscribe to get some more book recommendations. We'll see you soon.